Pues,
estuviste en Trieste, Mallorca, Santander.
Sí.
¿Sigues en activo allí?
Sigo en activo y me siguen, tengo que seguir tomando doctorados. He doctorado dos este año y viene el tuyo. Sigo en activo.
Roberto Deza, vicepresidente de IFIMAR, Instituto de Física y Matemáticas de Mar del Plata. Es un mar.
No, mathematics, but just physics. Mar es Mar del Plata.
Roberto has been a long friend and a long collaborator. In fact, he has some dark origins. He started doing some quantum theory of momentary particles. Long time ago. Actually, his first postdoc was at Santa Barbara. And then he saw the light and moved into different, more earthly topics. And he's been, besides this postdoc at Santa Barbara, he's been a postdoc at Santiago de Compostela for 4 years. And then shortly stays at Trieste, and he's still in Trieste, here in Mallorca, at the Instituto de Física and Calis. Okay. He's been doing many things, but today I see this is a new topic.
Well, it's an application of.
Okay. It's about this provision for the undriven Duffing.
Yeah, the idea is.
Finish. Is it what paper?
Oh.
Bueno,
si
breve.
Yes.
Maybe you should remove the. Okay.
The idea here is to incorporate inertia in a focal Planck scheme in a different way than Smoluchowski did. This is a work with my son. He's now at Bristol, and Horacio. And what I'm going to show is that for undamped autonomous nonlinear system with 1 degree of freedom, described by a Hamiltonian like that, the old Hamiltonian divided by the damping coefficient is a global Lyapunov function in the case that the damping is linear in the moment. We can prove this by two methods. One of them is path integration on the phase space of the system. And the other one is the non-equilibrium potential. We exploit the result to verify the Jarzynski relation past the pitchfork bifurcation of the undriven Duffing oscillator. We have notation, I'll use this one, X1, P over M is X2, and I rename V of X in this way. Okay. Along the first method, we also obtain the explicit form of a detailed fluctuation theorem, which is analog to this one. Here, G is the noise intensity, and the probabilities, these are the probabilities forward and backward for a given trajectory in configuration space. We verify numerically this theorem for the undriven Duffing oscillator to within an error of this order, quadratic error of that order. Well, the motivation, I've been lately collaborating with Daniel Lopez at Argonne National Laboratory. He does fabricates and does experiments on micro resonators, MEMS, micro electromechanic systems. And well, micro resonators have the flexibility in the design of their mechanical response, both extrinsic and intrinsic, and it's a dissipation mechanism, both intrinsic and extrinsic. Well, whereas some applications require fast damping, others require low dissipation rates. They are, of course, sources of interest in physics, and most experiments can be explained just by deterministic classical treatment. But, well, of course, when one reduces the dimensions of the vibrating structures, so increasing the resonance frequencies, the dynamic response becomes less and less linear. This generates strong instabilities that cause noise in the frequency response, and degrade their performance. So when the amplitude increases, the resonance frequency can move toward higher values or lower values for different cases. It can the frequency the resonance frequency. So this is captured by the model, by Duffing model, which just adds a cubic term to a linear oscillator. That cubic term can be can have either a positive or a negative coefficient. So, in the absence of damping, the Duffing model admits a Hamiltonian, where we assume that omega zero is positive, beta could be either positive or negative. Of course, I mean for when beta is very tiny. When when beta increases, of course, it must be positive, so the system is stable, and in that case, omega zero could be either positive or negative, so we have a pitchfork bifurcation. So we want to study nanoresonators. They are feasible, they are mechanical models of other systems like Josephson junctions, and we here classical deterministic treatment is not enough. It is submerged into thermal and quantum fluctuations. So, we try to use the tools we know for stochastic problems. For example, the non-equilibrium potential provides a global energy landscape, so it adds a quantitative dimension to the qualitative theory of differential equations. It provides useful information like heights of barriers, etc., for several stochastic problems. The first method is what one expects. We assume a forcing of a large one. The question is here. This, of course, whereas this has the dimensions of a velocity, this is an acceleration. So here, this has to have units of time to the minus one. Why gamma? We'll see that it comes out naturally. In qualitative terms, the noise provides external energy to the dissipative autonomous system, so that finally a statistical energy balance, a steady state, can be reached. So let's focus on the probability, the conditional PDF with initial conditions x1i, x2y, x2i, which we will call P, and under white noise with intensity D. Since P obeys a focal Planck equation, it is a Markov process in x1, x2 space, and that meets a path integral representation. But this this focal Planck equation has a second derivative term just with respect to x2 squared, so the diffusion matrix is singular. This difficulty can be overcome by performing the functional integral in the phase space of the variables and their canonically conjugate momentum. So the result is that we have now the reduced conditional PDF in configuration space under white noise with intensity D. It's that, and S has the inertia term incorporated. This is the exponential of S is the probability of a given trajectory in this space under a noise with intensity D. This reduced conditional PDF does not obey a Fokker Planck equation and is not even Markovian because of this term, but it can be useful in some terms. In some cases, for example, a measure of irreversibility is this, the log of the probability forward and over probability backward obtained on the same stochastic trajectory, but reversing the velocity. This gives rise to this detailed fluctuation theorem, which is, as I said, analog to this. You see that if either gamma or G tends to zero, the stochastic system must be conservative, this equal to zero, in order to be reversible.
That was so fast.
Huh?
That was so fast. Will you go back, man?
Sure.
So this is that PR should reduce conditional probability, but you need to still to specify the initial conditions for the distribution for the piece, for the momentum.
Yes, because yes, that's right. Well, that's right. You still have the initial conditions for the momenta, because you have integrated out just over the yes.
So assuming Gaussian distribution momentum.
Yeah.
You is that a proof? I mean, the backward and the forward is an identity or something you prove? This formula, H3B?
This?
No, the one H3B.
This?
Yeah.
This.
Is it a trivial identity or?
Yes, it is. Yes.
And then from there you obtain this formula?
Yes. Just by.
Which is the Hamiltonian, which is. Not concerned because of the
exception is in addition to changing the velocity, in addition to changing the velocity, we change the protocol.
Here there is no protocol. No. Yeah. So we have verified numerically. This occasion for 25.
If either gamma goes to zero,
yes,
or d goes to zero, stochastic.
If this is zero, you need. We have verified numerically this occasion for 25 stochastic trajectories of the undriven Duffing oscillator. We have chosen these values. We omega 0 1 sets the time scale through Hoyne integration with these values from the initial conditions from this initial, for which the we have this. Okay, and see that the theorem holds within a quadratic error of order 10 to the minus 7. Now, the second method is that of the non-equilibrium potential. What is it? For a non-component continuous time dissipative autonomous or dynamic flow, the integrability conditions to find a global Lyapunov function can be better poised for solution by considering the deterministic limit of the stochastic dynamic flow, this one, where this is a non-component vector of independent white noises with a common variance g. We consider the limit g to zero, and the sigma is just a constant matrix. So the non-equilibrium potential is defined as minus the limit of g times the log of the stationary PDF under noise g. So denoting q that way, it is symmetric. The stationary n variable Fokker Planck equation, which can be written this way, reduces in this limit to this one, which has the structure of a Hamilton-Jacobi equation in the gradient of phi. And this allows us, in principle, to obtain phi of x. In an attractor spacing, asymptotic stability imposes that that Q must be semi-positive definite. For G to zero, we find that phi dot is semi-definite negative, okay. And this is Lyapunov property. So phi of x is a Lyapunov function of the deterministic dynamics. So once one knows phi or the gradient of phi, the decomposition f equals g plus r with g this way, this is a tensor times the gradient reduces this Hamilton-Jacobi like equation to this one, which tells us that R is orthogonal to the gradient. Hence, G is the dissipative part and R the conservative one with respect to the non-equilibrium potential. In this case, for any value of D, not just D tending to zero, we find that phi is, has this expression. What about the conservative phi? It is still the Hamiltonian form in H. But now F is not Hamiltonian because of D. R different from zero is just what violates detailed balance, which in Lange von dynamics means stationary, that the stationary current is zero. If the average turnover frequency given by R of X is high enough, very fast, one can slowly vary the non-equilibrium potential and still obtain use this framework that is the adiabatic approximation. Well, we use the above result to obtain and verify numerically this equality. This is the work externally done through a protocol. Here there is a protocol. This is delta phi, and this is just a forward on the on a trajectory under the action of the protocol. In the case of inertia, when the protocol crosses the pitchfork bifurcation of the undriven model, we take beta positive, but we let omega zero square go from plus one to minus one. We have a in a time in an interval delta tau. We consider the undriven Duffing oscillator as a known beam. We move magnets and induce instability. The system passes from being monostable to being bistable, and that's the.
And this version of Jarzynski equality.
Yes.
Is valid as phi is always a Lyapunov
of the
family. Is it valid only in the
leading legal system? In order to establish a Jarzynski equality, you need delta phi. And this provides me delta phi.
Yeah, but it seems that if this case is only valid, if the motion of the rotation is sufficiently slow. So you are applying an external driving.
Yes. The protocol is a protocol. I do external work on the system. The system has inertia and has its own turnover frequency, but I do external work by means of a protocol, which in this case is this.
Yeah, but only if the speed in which this omega changes is slow is small enough.
External work must be adiabatic.
The assist equation is valid for any speed of the
motion.
So it's.
I'm not so sure.
Yes, so perhaps then it means that on this potential is only a two potential. The assist equation phi is a free energy. Mm-hmm.
So
this phi is the free energy only
So the system is in equilibrium, stationary distribution before and after the protocol. The work done on the system by the protocol is the integral of the power. Mu is here omega squared, omega zero squared, and dv, d mu is just x1 squared. So the work has this expression, and this is what has to be evaluated from an initial condition to a final condition, which has under the protocol, which has crossed the pitchfork bifurcation. We have verified numerically the equation before for 40 stochastic trajectories of the undriven Duffing oscillator, again with an error, a quadratic error of this one.
So is that true then for any tau, for any speed of the protocol?
That's what
tau for this?
Yeah. That's what the milieu implies. Yeah.
You check this Jarzynski relation, but in the limit of a small protocol, or
what? Tau has entered just enters here. So there's no limitation in principle.
So it's valid for any speed of the protocol?
An algebraic condition, I understand that what I obtained requires the algebraic condition in order to change the system. Yeah, but not here. Yeah.
Why do we scale the
word
with gamma d?
Here.
Okay.
Just because of, this is this is the power. I'm sorry, I don't remember just now why gamma appears here, but it's the way it came. This is the.
I mean, from the dimension.
The power,
point,
yeah.
Huh? From the dimension point of view.
Yeah, from the dimension.
You don't need gamma or d. I mean, the work is the potential.
I have to check because I don't remember the details. Just came this way, but came out this way, but now I can't. Can't give you. These are the conclusions which I already told you. I have to check that.
So this is one case we do have an exact Lyapunov experiment.
Yeah. Independent of the value of the noise intensity, you, as far as the damping is linear in the momentum, which
so what happens if your Lyapunov is only valid in the link of small noise. That would be a more interesting case.
Well,
in general, I don't know the Lyapunov potential for any. You wish you knew, but you usually don't. So, which are the chances of using this relation in this case?
Well, I just haven't tried the Jarzynski equation for any other ordinary non-equilibrium potential. I can try. Yeah, last year we found a non-equilibrium potential for the Wilson-Cohen model, a mean field model of the neural of the neocortex. We can try it. Yeah.
Great.
Any other questions or comments? Okay. Do we hear for today or?
Until Friday. Yeah.
Until Friday.
Okay.
University?
Well, I'll keep coming.
Okay, well, thank you. Okay.
Sí, tengo que.
No, por eso entró.
Tengo que revisar las cuentas
porque de
ahí no de aquí no sí, tienes razón. No, eso debe estar. Pero debe estar mal la expresión de Jarzynski, no la del trabajo. Bueno, acá aparece naturalmente. Claro, tú dices, en ese caso yo no tendría que poner pero los números dan muy bien. Eso es lo Algo fishy puede haber, pero tengo que revisarlo. Los números han dado muy bien, por eso.
Ya no.
Claro.
El trabajo es la